kiss your eyes and all that surround you are secrets and lies. I'll be your strength, I'll give you hope, keeping your faith when it's gone. The one you should call. Standing here all alone, and I will take you in my arms and hold you right where you belong until the day my life is through. This I promise you. I promise you. I've loved you forever in lifetimes before, and I promise you never will you hurt anymore. I give you my word.
Welcome everyone on this beautiful day. Jordan and Giselle have brought us together to celebrate their love and union in matrimony. Thank you all for joining us and being part of their love story. I'm especially excited to preside over this wedding after graduating with top honors from the Universal Life Church Ministry on my path of becoming a world-renowned reverend. Let's start with a short passage from the Bible. So the passage is 1 Corinthians 13, 4 through 8. It goes like this. Love is patient and kind. Love does not envy or boast. It is not arrogant or rude. It does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice at wrongdoing, but rejoices with the truth. Love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, and endures all things. Love never ends. So this is one of the most beautiful verses in the entire world, and the entire Bible itself. But has anyone ever stopped to think what this all means? Love is hard. It is not easy. It is not perfect. We have been brainwashed by movies and TV shows that show perfect couples in perfect marriages. But that's all fiction. There's not such thing as perfection in this world, even though some come close to it. We can never be completely perfect. Love is not perfect, but don't misunderstand. It might sound negative, but it's actually the most wonderful thing in the world. Love is something that you have to work on for the rest of your life. Love is something that will never be done, which means that for the rest of your life, you will have to love each other every day. But what is the love I'm talking about? It's not the butterflies you feel in your stomach when you see each other. It is not the warm feeling you're in when you're in each other's embrace. It is not even the words that come out of your mouth when you say I love him? No, love is sacrifice. I'll say it again, in case you didn't hear me. Love is sacrifice. But I'm not talking about the grand sacrifice you see on movies. I'm not talking about ripping up your heart and giving it to her when she needs to. I'm talking about the everyday sacrifices that you do for each other. Like watching a movie or show that you hate, but she loves, just to see her smile. Love is going to watch him do tricks on his bike and help him get up when he falls. Love is putting down anything you're doing to hear each other complain about work, or family, or friends, or that bastard that cut you off on your way home. Love is supporting and advising each other on everything you do, on applying to new jobs or accepting new jobs in other states. Love is crying with each other when you're sad. Love is laughing with each other when you're happy. Love is talking to each other every day about everything. Love is not keeping secrets, even the ones your best friend tells you. Love is letting her decorate the house however she wants. But love is letting him display that one figure or poster or books or art that he has had for most of his life. Love is also giving each other space from time to time, letting him play video games, or letting her hang out with her friends. Love is accepting each other, the good and the bad. Love is not blaming each other or throwing fault around. Love is not remembering the things you said to each other in the heat of the moment, but remembering all the small things you do for each other. All the nights he wakes up in the middle of the night because you're thirsty and you need water. All the jokes he laughs at, even the bad ones. All the times he has been there for you and you have been for him. Love is doing what makes her happy, even if you don't want to. Love is doing what makes him happy, even if you don't want to. Love is being each other's waitress, therapist, consultant, boss, employee, cook, cleaning lady, and everything you do every day. Love is being one thing, always and forever. As you can see, love is many more. You will annoy each other, get angry, and even scream. But the most important thing to remember is that no matter what happens, always be true with each other. Always talk to each other, no matter how mad you might be, or what the other person might have done or said. Open up your heart with each other, and you will be able to get through everything together. The good and the bad times, because they will come. And if you support each other, there's nothing that you cannot overcome. Never put anything before each other, not family, money, friends, or work. But support each other when it comes to family, when it comes to money, when it comes to friends, when it comes to work. If you keep all these in your heart, the both of you will have a marriage stronger than anybody in the history of this world. But enough about this life lesson. Let's go ahead and make the greatest promise to each other. So before God, your friends, and family, I ask you to affirm your willingness to enter the covenant of marriage and to share all the joys and sorrows of your life and your relationships, whatever the future may hold. So Jordan, do you take this woman to be your wife? Do you promise to love him, comfort him, honor him? Jordan, do you take this woman to be your wife? Do you promise to love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health as long as both of them live? Just said it. Do you take this man to be your husband? Do you promise to love him, comfort him, honor and keep him, in sickness and health, as long as both shall live?
truth.
Now, I've heard that you both each other wrote vows for each other. So we're going to go ahead and we're going to let Jordan go first.
Easily. We have been together for almost 3 years, and it not only has been pure bliss and happiness, but it feels like I've known you forever. Since our first interaction, I knew that there was something about you that made me feel something that I had never felt. And I was immediately intrigued. It didn't take long for me to understand that that unknown feeling was realizing that you embody everything I had ever imagined wanting in a wife, a friend, and a life partner. From a young age, my mother would tell me that Jesus had a special woman who would be everything I could ever want and need picked out for me. I was always thinking to myself, like, yeah, right. But the day I met you, I knew that that blessing my mom would speak about. I love you more than anything I ever knew I could. I love you more than I ever knew I could ever love a person. And it grows more each and every day. You gave me a whole new outlook on life and where I wanted to end up at the end. And I honestly do not know what I would do if it wasn't for the little old Spencers and Jesus Christ. With that being said, I vow to carry you and to be carried by you in this journey of life and to cherish every second of it. I vow to always appreciate the little things about you, like how you snorkel when you laugh too hard or put ketchup on mac and cheese. I vow to bring optimism and hope into our marriage and to be your strength and support in my life pushes as well. I vow to love you from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to be cherished till death do us part. According to God's holy law, in the presence of God, I make this vow to you today.
I'll give you that. Well, as she's going, she'll get the ring. Skip a step. And we're going to move on to the sad ceremony. So it is Jocelyn Jordan. Come to the table behind me.
Jordan and Jocelyn, today you are here to join your separate lives together. The two separate bottles of sand in front of you symbolize your separate lives, separate families, and separate sets of lives. They represent all that you are and all that you'll ever be as individuals. They also represent your lives before today. So you can go ahead and pick up your bottle and uncork them. As these two containers of sand are poured into the third one, the individual containers of sand will no longer exist. But when we join together as one, just as the great sand can never be separated, so will we remain.
From the earliest of times, the circle has been the symbol of completeness, a symbol of committed love, and unbroken and never-ending commitment. These rings shall be a reminder of the commitment to love each other that you have made today. Jordan, repeat after me. I, Jordan, give you this ring, a symbol of my commitment to love, honor, and respect. I, Jocelyn, give Jordan this ring as a symbol of my commitment to love, honor, and respect. May God bless you and keep you, Jordan and Jocelyn, by the power vested in me. I now pronounce you husband and wife. Jordan, you may now take your way. It is my pleasure to present you Mr. and Mrs. Valdez.
This day I've never found someone 18. Now I'm Zell's sister-in-law. That's crazy, right? So let's see. I've known Zell for, I believe it's a little over 2 years ago. I believe. Oh, yeah. Okay. Let's see. And I guess I remember the first time we met. I won't go into details. It wasn't too pretty, but it was a night to remember. But I knew from the first night that she was perfect for my brother. For the longest time, I couldn't really imagine who would want to date my brother or marry him. It's Jordan. But then she came along, and I didn't think it was possible for there to be a female version of him. And that hurt it completely. Let's see. I lost my spot. I don't know. I'm so thankful for you, and I'm so thankful that you make my brother so happy, because I haven't seen him like this in so long, and it makes my heart full. And I'm happy to see everybody here today. But for those of you who don't know, my mommy and papa, our mommy and papa, they couldn't make it. Let's see, but I know that if they were here, they'd be smiling ear to ear with love for both of y'all, because they love you both so much. And they're both so happy that they found each other. So, cheers to y'all. I love y'all so much.
Hello, everyone.
You're moving next to the bride. Can you go out?
Okay. Hi, I'm Iseli's cousin, Melissa. I've obviously known Iseli for quite some time. And, you know, I have never seen her as happy as she, as she is today. So I'm just going to leave you guys with some little, you know, cute, inspirational quotes, okay? So they say a person needs just three things to be truly happy in this world. Someone to love, something to do, and something to hope for. So today, here, you guys have each other to love. Tomorrow, you'll have something to do. And for the rest of your lives, you have your future to hope for. So here's to forever.
And I truly doubt that I will.
He showed me what true friendship is, and it's not a standard that I hold for everyone else. I learned how to be more patient and forgiving from her, because no matter what stressful situation she is, she will always choose kindness, even when I really don't know why. But that's just who she is. She'll bring the best out of any situation she is in, and she continues to astound me with who she is even after all these years. There's no one else in the world that I believe deserves a happy ending and a happy ever after more than you. And I'm so happy that you found it. Congratulations again on your happiness, and I wish you both a life of peace and joy.
I don't know how I follow all that. Good evening. I hope everyone is having a good time. I want to offer my warmest greetings to all the wonderful family and friends that can be here on the most special occasion. Allow me to introduce myself. My name is Kendra. Some of you may not know me, but Izeli is one of my best friends. I have known her for about 10 years now. We met in high school. We had similar friends who would come together during study groups during lunch, and come to find out, we had classes together, and we started to get to know one another, and something just clicked. Days became months, and months turned into years, and over those years, she became a big part of my life, and came to mean the world to me. She's the sister I never had, and for those of you who don't know, I grew up with three older brothers, only girl in my family. We have been through thick and thin together, through the good times and bad, breakups, arguments, and even a few hangovers. We've shed tears and shared a whole lot of laughter, created memories that we will never forget, and maybe one day we'll share them with our kids. Now, when I was Googling wedding speeches, there were three key points to hit. Thank everyone for coming, talk about the bride, and mention the groom. So don't think I forgot about you, Jordan. I remember when I first met Jordan, or heard about Jordan, really. Izeli was telling me about this guy that she worked with at Spencer's. Totally her type. He had the same taste in music as her. He was funny. He had tattoos and even had similar personality and tendencies. Naturally, I was intrigued in who this fellow was who caught my best friend's eye. So of course, I'm like, do you have a picture? Because I already have the idea of him in my head, and now I just need to see a face. Sure enough, he was really handsome, and at this point, I'm just egging her on and like, you should investigate this guy. As time goes on, their friendship blossomed into a relationship, and of course, now I'm just dying to meet this guy. To be honest, our first encounter wasn't the best, being that I met them on a day that they were both working, so we didn't really get to talk much. It was just a quick hi and bye. Me and Izeli never really had the same schedule, so I really didn't get to meet Jordan until almost about a year later. Fast forward to January 28th, 2021, the day that we actually met, because thanks to COVID, we didn't actually get... All in all, it was a great night. I got to catch up with my best friend and got to meet the man who makes her happy. Jordan, you are one lucky guy. Izeli is one of the best people that I've had the privilege to meet and call with my family. She's got a heart of gold and the purest soul, and I'm glad that she's found somebody to protect it. To the most beautiful bride that I've ever seen and the luckiest guy in the world, I wish y'all nothing but happiness.
Alright, so Jordy Beats over here, you know. I never thought I would see him get married. I mean, when I left Texas 2016, he was a different person. And Zells, I'm happy you came into his life. You changed him. He's a happy man. That's all that matters. So, I suppose. Yeah. Oh, Georgie Beats, that's my brother. So, there you go.
Hi everyone, thank you for coming out tonight and celebrating this day for Jordan and Zelly. I've known Jordan since I was, 11 years old, Jordan? So it's been about 13 years, and I'm just glad he could find somebody that shares so much in common with him and makes him so happy that he doesn't even want to go out anymore, you know? But, you know, I'm happy for y'all. I wish y'all nothing but the best.
Hi guys, my name's Armando, and honestly I can't believe this day came and we're standing right here. Keep in mind, when I first moved to Katy, back in the day I used to be the shyest guy in the world. I could not speak to a single soul. And you know who came up to me and said, "What's up?" This guy right here. I'm just gonna tell you something, man. The rest was history, man. And I'm just glad to see him happy. You know, there's always hurdles in life, you know. And we all got through, and I was happy. Wish you the best with him. Wish all the best.
How's it going, guys? For those of you who don't know me, my name is Mason. I'm Jordan's friend. Known him a little over 10 years. It's really funny how we actually met. Probably shouldn't get too into it, but throughout the time that I've known him, he's always been a really good friend. He's actually responded to a lot of my calls and texts before a lot of other people have. So, you know, he's all around a good person. And I'm glad that you guys actually found something that nowadays is something really rare. You know, you seem really happy, and that makes me happy. I'm glad you guys had a nice evening. So I wish y'all nothing but the best. Congratulations.
For those of y'all who don't know me, I'm Alfredo. I'm one of Jordan's friends, and I'm also Armando's brother. And I'm gonna make it quick and short, you know. I've known Jordan for almost close to 10-9 years. And I'm just gonna say this, ever since I heard about Sally and talking about her, I just knew she was gonna be a winner. So, and ever since I met her, she was. And I wanna say thank you for having me to be part of your wedding, you know. And I hope you all have a happy life. Thank you so much.
Well, hello there. As everybody knows, I'm Jordan's dad. I've known him all his life. But I just want to say thanks for coming out, and friends, family, everybody. I don't even know where to start with, you know, the experiences that we have shared. You know, it's too long, you know. But I know that Jordan's happy, and that's all that counts.
surround you. Bring tears to your eyes. And all that surround you are secrets and lies. I'll be your strength. I'll give you hope. Keeping your faith when it's gone. The one you should call. Standing here all alone. And I will take you in my arms and hold you right where you belong. Until the day my life is through, this I promise you. I promise you.